Hello. Okay, today we're going to first solve this problem. So here is the question. It says that prove that the mapping. So it's given a mapping from the vector space R3 to the vector space R3, and the mapping is defined by T of x, y, z equals to x plus y. So we get another vector where the first coordinate of the vector is x plus y, second coordinate is y plus z, and third coordinate is z plus x. This is defined for all x, y, z belongs to R3. And what we have to show? We have to show that T is a one-to-one mapping. Okay, so let's do it. So here we go. Here we have the mapping T of x, y, z is x plus y, y plus z, and z plus x. So for particular value, let's give work with some particular points. So if I take T of 1, 0, and 2, so it gives us so 1 plus 0. So here x is 1, y is 0, and z is 2. And then we get 0 plus 2, and last we get 2 plus 1. So after that, what we get? 1, 2, and 3. So that's how the mapping is defined. So we put any value of R3 and we get another vector of R3. So what we have to show that T is 1 to 1. So we have to show T is 1 to 1. So we know from previous results that T is 1 to 1 if and only if kernel of T. So T is 1 to 1 implies by kernel of T contain the zero vector of V. So V is here is R3. So what is the zero vector of R3? Is 0, 0, 0. So this contain this zero vector which it components is 0, 0, and 0. So what we have to show? We have to show that kernel of T is only this vector. So let's find kernel of T for this mapping. So we know the kernel of T is the collection of all vector, here the vector from R3, such that T of x, y, and z, so here this is y, which have to be equals with 0, 0, and 0. So if it is that, so suppose we have taking any element. So let's for example let a b c let a comma sorry for my handwriting b and c belongs to kernel of T. So if it is in kernel of T, then obviously this satisfies this property. So the property says that if I have the any elements in the set, then it's transformed to, so any vector A, B, C transformed to, so T of A, B, C, so it's the transformation is equals to zero vector of R3. So this gives, so what is the definition of T of A, B, C? So T of X, Y, Z is given in this way. So any point, so here x is a, y is b, and z is c. So if we do that, so we get the point a plus b, b plus c, and c plus a, which is equals to 0, 0, and 0. So this implies that the first component, so this, because these two vectors of R3 are equal, so each component of the vector have to be equal with each other. So here we get a plus b, that's must equals to this component 0. So a plus b have to be equals to 0. So so this is equation 1. B plus c equals to 0, so equations 2, and C plus A also equals to 0, so equation 3. Now if I solve these three equations, you can pause the video, please pause the video and work it with yourselves, and you will find that, so after you solving this equation 3, we will find A equal to B equals to C equals to 0. So this is the only solutions of these three equations. So because kernel of T, we take any elements because this vector is arbitrary from the kernel of T. So what we get basically, so we get, so let me write down that, so kernel of T, so it is this part, so kernel of T, so let me write down over here, so here we go, so kernel of T is the collection of all vector A, B, C such that what we get A equals to B equals to C equals to 0. So that means kernel of T contain only 0, 0, 0. We put the value of A over here 0, B over here 0 and C also. So we get the kernel of T only contain the 0 vectors. Because kernel of T only contain the 0 vectors, so T is an 1 to 1 map. So let me write down, so just erase this part. I'm taking the time for erasing the all these parts, but I have to do it. So sorry for that, I am taking your time. So T is 1 to 1 mapping. So T is 1 to 1 mapping. So that is our first thing that we have to do. Okay. Let's go to the problem number 2, but first let me erase the whole parts. So here we go, so we have to, if I erase the whole part, so I have to take time to erase this whole part. Okay, Control A. Okay, let forget about all that thing. So here is the question number 2, so just let me give you the more valuable way to check it, where this, here is the questions, so question is over here. So it says that determine the linear mappings, which is again a mapping from R3 to R2. Okay, so we have to determine this mapping. So mapping is not given over here. So in this example, you can see that here we have the value of mapping. Mapping is given over here in this example. But here, instead of given the mapping, it's given that the value of the mapping at some basis point. So it's given that at the point T110. So let me write down. So what is given? So in this problem, so here it is given. So given is T of 100, the value of T of 110 is 11. So it's given. So next, what is the value of T010? Is 23. So let me write down that. So value of T of 010 is 2,3. And also the value of 001 is also given. So value of 001 is 32. So these three thing are given. So these three are provided. So what we have to find, we have to determine the mapping T. So determines means we have to find T in some form of like this. So not exactly this form, but some form of like this. So we have to find out that. So what we do, suppose we go with some particular points. So that means, suppose if we have to find the what will be the value of T of 1, 2, minus 3. So if we have to find only that portion. So what we will do basically, because, so here we do, so in this process we do for any general point. So what we do, we write, first write 1, 2, minus 3, because we know that 001 is a basis of R3. So 2 1 2 minus 3 can be written as, so let me write down, so it can be written as 1 into 100, so 1 into 100 plus, so what we can write, plus 2 into 010 plus, what we can write, we write that 3 into, so 3 is a scalar and we have a vector, so combination of these three vectors. So we can write 1, 2, minus 3 as a combination of these three vectors. Now, we, if I, because it is given that T is a linear transformation. So what we know, because T is a linear transformation, we can use the property of linear transformation. So we get T of 1 to minus 3 equals to scalar into T of 1 0 0. This is the property of linear transformation, 2 into T of 0 1 0 plus 3 into T of 0 0 1. So we know this is from the property of linear transformation. So let me remind you again. So how we get this part? So what we know about linear transformation? Linear transformation take any vector alpha plus beta to T of alpha plus T of beta. So this is the first part. Second part is take A into alpha is A into T of alpha. Now instead of that, if we have A alpha plus B beta, so what we do? So A is a scalar, alpha is a vector, B is a scalar, beta is a vector. So A into alpha, scalar into vector is a vector. So this is one vector, and B into beta is another vector. So what we know from here? So suppose this is alpha 1, think it is alpha 1, so think this is beta 1. So T of alpha 1 plus beta 1 can be written as T of alpha 1 plus T of beta 1. So T of A alpha plus T of B beta. Okay, now use this formula. T of A alpha equals to A into T of alpha. So we use this formula. So we get A into T of alpha plus B into T of beta. So we use this formula. So scalar into, so if we have something like that, scalar into vector plus scalar into vector, so we can write A into T of scalar into T of vectors plus B into T of vector. So we do it over here. So we take T of 1 2 minus 3 is as T of whole this part, and we write is scalar into T of vector plus scalar into T of vector plus scalar into T of vector. So now what is given? So it is given that the value of T of 1 0 0. So it's given that T of 1 0 0 is 1 1. So we put the value. So 1 1. So next 2 into the value of T of 0 1 0 is given. So it's 2 3. So we put that value 2 3 plus 3 into. So value of T of 0 0 1 is also given. So it is 3 2. So we put the value, so we get 3 2. So how, what is get after addition all this? So here we 1, 2 into 2 is 4, 3 into 3 is 9. So 9 plus 4 is 13 plus 1 is 14. So here we get 1, 3 into 2 is 6 plus 3 into 2 is 6, and we get 13. So we get the point 13 plus 14 plus 13. So we find out the value of particular point of R3 or particular vector of R3, and we know what will be the transformation value. So we now going to work in similar way to find any value of for the general point. So first let me erase the whole part. So if I erase the whole part, so first what we do, so first any vector, so any vector of R3 is of the form, so let me write that down. So any vector of R3 is of the form x comma y comma z. Now write, try to write or try to express x, y, z as a linear combination of the vectors 1 0 0 0 1 0 and 0 0 1. So we write x, y, z as 1 0 0 plus b into 0 1 0 plus c into 0 0 1. What we going to do, we're going to find the value of a, b and c. But before that, what we know basically, because t is a linear transformation, so we can write t of x, y, z as a into t of 1 0 0 plus b into scalar, b is a scalar, so t of 0 1 0 plus c into T of 0, 0 and 1. So this is from the property of T is a linear transformation. So what we know? We know the value of T of 1, 0, 0. T of 1, 0, 0 is, we just put the value. So T of 1, 0, 0 is 1, 1 plus B into what is the value of T of 0, 1, 0. So it's 2, 3 plus C into value of T of 0, 0, 1. So it's 3, 2. So after that, so now we have to first find the value of A, B and C. We put the value and we get the transformation value of the vector x, y, z. So our task is to find the value of A, B and C. So pause the video for a few seconds and do it for yourselves. I will do also by myself. So here we go. So we have to erase the whole parts over here to find that value. So first I erase this part. So pause the video and do it for yourselves, don't copy me. So here we go. If I do in this way, so we get A comma, so what we get, sorry, what we have to write, actually I made a mistake, I think. So oh yeah, we don't have to basically, no, not a made a mistake, sorry for that. So B and C, so ABC, so this implies x equals to A. We made a mistake that I erased all the parts. B, y equals to B, because x, y, z is same as ABC. So we get y equals to B, z equals to C. So this is the value of A, B and C. So value of A is x, value of B is y and value of C is z. So now T of x, y, z obviously equals to what we have, A into 1, 1 plus we have B into 2, 3 plus what we have, C into 3, 2. Now put the value of A, B and C. So A equals to X, so we get 1, 1. So B is Y, so 2, 3 and C is Z. So put the value, we get 3, 2. After addition all that part, what we get, X plus 2Y plus 3z and x plus 3y plus 2z. So we get in this way. So that is the how the value of T of x, y, z. So we determine the mapping. Now what we have to check, we have to check T is 1 to 1 or not. So that is the next part of the question. So what we have to check, we have to check that T is not a 1 to 1 map. So prove that T is not a 1 to 1 map. So that we have to check that T is not 1 to 1 map. So for that, what we know, so T is 1 to 1 map if the kernel of T contain only the 0 vectors. So what we do in this way. So we just erase the whole parts over here. So first remind it, so don't erase, let me not erase this part. So x plus 2y plus 3z comma x plus 3y plus 2z, we're going to find kernel. So first erase the upper portions, so just erase the upper portions of the vectors. So here we go, so we erase the whole parts of the vectors, sorry, whole part of the board. Okay, so what we have to find, we have to find the kernel of the vectors. So kernel of T, so kernel of T, if I show that kernel of T not equals to the 0 vector of R2 or R3, so remember that kernel of T, here we have the subset of R3, so is the vector 0, 0, 0. So if I show that kernel of T not equals to 0, 0, 0, then we can say that T is not a 1 to 1 map. So first find the kernel. So kernel of T is the contain all vectors of R3 x, y, z such that T of x, y, z goes to the 0 vector. So here T is a mapping from R3 to R2. So here, because we have a mapping to R2, so T of x, y, z is in vector of R2, so this equals to 0, 0, because 0, 0 is the 0 vector, so order pair 0, 0 is the 0 vector of R2, so T of x, y, z is 0, 0. Okay, so now what we do, suppose any arbitrary element. So let any ABC, let any ABC belongs to kernel of T. So if it is in kernel of T, so then that is by the property. So what is that means? It means T of ABC obviously equals to 0, 0. So what is the value of T of ABC? So ABC, we know that here X is A, Y is B and Z is C. So what we know from here, so this gives A plus 2B plus 3C equal comma, sorry, this have to be comma, so not end it over here, so it's have to be comma over here. So here we have comma plus A plus 3B plus 2C, that have to be equals to 0 comma 0. So this implies that A plus 2B plus 3C equals to 0 vector, and sorry, not the 0 vector, the scalar 0, and A plus 3B plus 2C is also equals to 0. So if we do that, so let this is equation 1 and this is equation 2. So what we do, we are going to solve these two equations and find the value of A, B and C. So what we have find out, so let's do it for now. So write down, in this way, so A equal B and C. So what is A by 2, 4 minus 9, so it will be minus 5. B will be, so recheck the calculations, so 3 minus 2, so 3 minus 2 is 1, and here we go, 3 minus 2 again, so which is 1, so this is equals to K, say. So what we know, so A implies, this implies A have to be equals to minus 5K, K is any real number, B is equals to K, C is also equals to K. Please recheck the calculations. The process is same, but you have to check the calculations. So what we know that if I put the different value of K, we get the different ABC. So here we go. So just erase this part. So you know that. So if I put, so kernel of T is, so kernel of T, so let me write it down. So kernel of T is the collection of A, B, C. Here we go. A is minus 5K, B is K and C is K. K is any real number. K is any real number. So what we get? So we get minus 5K. K comma K, K is any real number. So you can see that, sorry for my handwriting again. So if I put, you can clearly check that this is clearly not equals to only the 0 vector 0 0 0, because for K equals to 1, it is not equals to 0 0 0, because for K equals to 1, if I put K equals to 1, what we get? We get the point minus 5 1 1, and this is belongs to the kernel of T. You can also check from the definitions also what we have determined the value. So kernel of T already contain one vector which is not zero vector, so kernel of T not the zero vectors. So from that results we have done in our previous lectures, from that we can easily say that from that results it's conclude that T is not a one-to-one map. So let me write down, so here we go, so T is not a one-to-one map. So for one-to-one map, if it is T is a one-to-one map, then kernel of T only have to be equal with this singleton set. But here we saw that kernel of T is not equals to the singleton set. That's why kernel of T is not a one-to-one map. I hope you understand the problem. If you not, just comment below and or ask me later by phone or something else. Thank you.